गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर जी पाटिल, केके कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी नासिक। तो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ऑन वाटर ट्रीटमेंट्स। ओके, तो फर्स्टली व्हाट इज नीडेड तो टू किल ऑल पैथोजेनिक जर्म्स व्हिच आर हार्मफुल टू ह्यूमन हेल्थ, आल्सो टू रिमूव द अनप्लीजेंट एंड ऑब्जेक्शनेबल टेस्ट एंड ऑडर्स फ्रॉम द वाटर, आल्सो टू रिमूव डिसॉल्व्ड गैसेस कलर ऑफ वाटर, आल्सो टू मेक वाटर फिट फॉर डोमेस्टिक इंडस्ट्रियल एंड कमर्शियल यूजेस, so to remove microorganisms and collider matters. Okay, that is the importance of water treatment process. So this is the view of water treatments from reservoir to home. The first water, then screening, coagulants added, then sedimentation, then filtration, then pH correction, also anti-correction, corrosion agent, okay, anti-corrosion agents also, then chlorination and to homes. Okay, finally to homes after chlorination, means generally disinfection process as a chlorinations. The firstly, from water is drawn from the lakes, rivers, reservoirs, okay, and can be drawn from groundwater, okay, also using boreholes for raw water. The first treatment is screening. Okay, the screening helps to remove large matter from the water such as leaves, also rubbish, also using wire mesh in screening. That this prevents the debris from the causing obstructions within the facility, making treatment easier. Okay, so this is the screening using number of large impurities, okay, removed from the water firstly by screening. Okay, means coarse screening, also fine screening use. Then coagulants add such as aluminium sulfates and ferric chlorides, okay, are mostly used coagulants in water for water treatment process. That this makes the particles of dirt and dissolved substances in the water means clump together so that they can be removed easily. Okay, means firstly suspended collider matters in water, okay, means fine solid matter suspended in water. So these are not means settle down at the bottom of sedimentation tank. Okay, the coagulants add before sedimentation to clump the solid matters, okay, colloidal solid matters, okay, stabilize the particles by coagulants add in water, okay, then transfer water into sedimentation tank. So under the slow mixing, okay, the clump particles increase in size, also in process called as flocculations, okay, means coagulants and then process is flocculation, flock is formed to increase the size of particles, okay, then increase the gravity, also surface means density of the particles that time easily settle down at the bottom side and easily remove from the sedimentation tank from the water, okay, and then water transfer to filtration process. Okay, the generally water transfer in a number of layers of soils, mean generally through the bed of soil and stuff, carbon, sand, gravels, okay, silt. The some particles remain in the water after sedimentations, so these are removed by filtrations through coal, sand and gravel beds, okay, so they are cleaned by pumping air and water back out, means generally back water means backwashing through them, okay. So next is pH corrections, means water that too acidic, okay, can be base, can lead to water by corrosions. It can be fast through the containing, okay, means crust of limes, calcium carbonates, okay, that time correct the pH of the water, okay, means to retain the corrosion property of water, means at the time of water entering in piping systems, okay. Also then anti-corrosion agents also add in water. The agents such as add in water generally particular areas with the lead pipes. Okay, so they use anti-corrosion agents. The agent form lead phosphide compliance on the inside of the pipes, stopping lead getting into the water. Okay, so this is also anti-corrosion agent. And then last process is disinfection process, means generally chlorine add in water in the form of liquid powder. Okay, so gases form. So generally chlorination is added to water to kill bacteria and viruses, preventing waterborne diseases like cholera, typhoids. Okay, also ozone can be added instead of chlorine and avoids disinfection by products. Okay, also ozone add in water replacement of chlorine. Okay, and then final disinfection process is done. Okay, then water transfer to homes. Okay, finally distribute to home. So this is the water treatment from reservoir to home. Okay, the detailed study in next step wise, the first is raw water collections and from reservoir, lakes, dams. Okay, I mean generally this is the raw water receiving in a water treatment plant. Okay, then in the stages, first is screening the removal of any floating objects like leaves, branches, fishes, weeds, okay, from the water. Then the mechanical screening also used, means this is the fine screening, means remaining particles, okay, means not completely removed by core screening. So these materials removed from the mechanical screening. Okay, then aeration. Aeration is also important treatment water. So dissolving oxygen into water to remove small smell and taste, promote helpful bacteria to grow and precipitate noxious metals like iron and manganese. Okay, I mean generally dissolving oxygen into water that time to remove smell and taste. Okay, means promote helpful bacteria to grow and precipitate noxious metals like iron and manganese. Okay, so this is the aeration process is done in figures. This is the spray aerator's nozzles. Okay, this is the slat type aerators also used for aeration. Then sedimentation, the removal of suspended matters having higher specific gravity than water and so fine suspended matters. Okay, so these are sedimentation tanks. Okay, in water treatment plants. Major cleanup, the first coagulation flocculation. Okay, after screening, the first is causes the agglomeration and sedimentation of suspended solid particles through the addition of coagulant agent, usually aluminum sulfate and iron sulfate, to the raw water along with polymer to help form of flocks. Okay, means it generally increase the size of particles. The filtrations remove microorganisms and colloidal matters. Okay, by using a bed of soil. Okay, strata of soil consist of carbon, gravel, sand, silt. Okay, then disinfection, the pre-chlorination and dechlorinations mostly to kill algae that will otherwise grow and clog the water filters. Also kills much of the remaining unprotected bacteria from water. Okay, also softening is also one of the important treatment to remove the hardness of water. Okay, by removing number of means minerals. Okay, calcium, magnesium, means excess calcium, magnesium. Okay, that time softening process to remove hardness. Then coagulation, the firstly theory of coagulation means is the destabilization of colloids by addition of chemicals that neutralize the negative charges. Okay, the chemicals are known as coagulants. The coagulation is sincere chemical process. Okay, the mixing devices, this is the mixing device, horizontal or round type mixing basin with baffle walls also provided. Also mixing basin with mechanical devices for rapid mixing. Okay, the number of baffles spread inside for proper mixing. Okay, the rapid or flash mixing is the process by which coagulant is rapidly and uniformly dispersed through the mass of water. This process usually occurs in small basin immediately preceding or at the head of coagulation basin. Okay, the generally detention period is 30 to 60 seconds and the head loss is 20 to 60 centimeters of water. Okay, here colloids are destabilized and thus nucleus for flock is formed. Okay, the rapid or flash mixing used for forming flocculation for coagulant add and then water transfer in rapid or flash mixing, also slow mixing for proper disperse coagulants through the mass of water. Okay, slow mixing brings the contacts between the finely divided destabilized matter formed during rapid mixing. Okay, the coagulation aim, the firstly coagulant add into impurities, in generally these are impurities present in water. The coagulant add in this water, then coagulant form precipitate trapping impurities. Okay, the clamp together then increase the size. Okay, we generally in third form. Okay, these are the flocks form at the gravity. Okay, density increases, size of particle increases, that time easily settle down at the bottom side. Okay, the flocculation is generally agglomeration of destabilized particles into large size particles known as flocks, which can be physically removed by sedimentation or flotation. Okay, the mechanical flocculators. Okay, cross flocculator sections view. Okay, so this is the flocculator. Then hydraulic flocculators also provided in water treatment plants. The horizontal baffle tanks, water flows horizontally. Baffle walls helps to create turbulence and thus facilitate mixing properly. Then vertical baffle tank also in flocculations tanks. Water flows vertically, baffle walls helps to create turbulence and thus facilitate mixing. Okay, I mean same principle, vertical baffle tank and horizontal baffle tanks. Hydraulic flocculators. This is also hydraulic flocculators, simple technology. Then clarifier. After flocculation, water enters the settling tank, which is commonly called as clarifier. So combining clarifloculator in modern practices, flocculator and clarifier provided in one unit called clarifloculator, in which chamber is provided in the center and clarifier compartment is formed by the peripheral space. Okay, this is the clarifloculator. This is the clarifloculator. Okay, it consists of inlet pipe, scraping, arm lifting devices, also high torque center drive, platforms, intake well, flocculator, bellar, central shaft, scraper arms, and central scraper. Okay, when generally done, clarification and flocculation is also at the same time is done. Okay, in clarifloculator, these are clarifiers. Okay, actually in water treatment plants. Filtration, next step is filtrations. The process of passing the water through the bed of such granular materials is known as filtrations. The two types of filtration generally used, the slow sand gravity filter. Okay, slow sand gravity filter and rapid sand filter. The slow sand filters are used in water purification for treating raw water to produce potable product. Okay, I mean generally they are typically 1 to 2 meters deep, can be rectangular or cylindrical in cross section, and are used primarily to treat surface water. The periodically clean by removing, also cleaning and replacing the upper few inches of biological active sand. Okay, generally periodically clean by removing, cleaning, replacing upper few inches of biological active sand from the slow sand filters. This is the filter and their classifications. This is a slow sand filter, consists of inside the structure, means generally bed of soil, water transfer. Okay, means then percolates the water through the strata of soil. Okay, that time impurities prevent. Okay, the upper layer of the sand. Okay, that time water transfer means generally filtration process. Okay, is done and then outlet. Okay, then rapid sand filters. The rapid sand filter is a purely physical drinking water purification method. Means rapid sand filters provide rapid and efficient removal of relatively large suspended particles. The two types of rapid sand filters are typically used, rapid gravity filters and rapid pressure sand filters. Okay, the biggest disadvantage of slow sand filter is that it requires large area due to slow filtration rate. Okay, that means the slow sand filters, that is the one of the disadvantages, requires large area due to slow filtration rate. Also, this requirement make it uneconomical for places where land is very costly in urban areas. Okay, in order to reduce requirements of space and to increase the rate of filtration, the lot of research conducted which finally lead to the develop of rapid sand filter. Okay, generally in order to reduce requirements of space and to increase the rate of filtrations, that time lot of research on sand filters. Okay, develop rapid sand filter. Rapid sand filters have filter rates 40 times those of slow sand filters. The major parts of rapid sand filter are filter tank or filter box, then filter sand or mixed medium, then gravel support bed, under drain system, wash water troughs, also filter bed agitators. Okay, then pressure filters. Generally two types of rapid filters, the gravity based or pressure filters. The pressure filters are used extensively in iron and manganese removal plants. Okay, they are generally used in iron and manganese removal plants. A pressure sand filter is contained under pressure in steel tank, which may vertical or horizontal depending on the space available, as with gravity filters. Okay, and generally same, the media is usually sand or combination of media, and filtration rates are similar to gravity filters. But change only generally extends will you use in iron and manganese removal plants. But precious sand filter is contained under pressure and steel tank. Okay. Groundwater is first aerated to oxidize the iron and manganese and then pumped through the filter to remove the suspended materials. Okay. So these are pressure sand filters. Okay. Thank you, students.